Philippine Senator Sherwin Gatchalian calling for better regulation of electronic gaming to prevent a repeat of the crime proliferation seen in the pogo industry. E-gaming refers to online games that take bets from local sources. Gatchalian also counting on revenue from e-games to compensate for the losses caused by the closure of pogos. Now, in 2023, PAGCOR earned more than 22 billion pesos from e-games. That's nearly four times what it earned in 2021. Gatchalian's Senate Committee on Ways and Means is currently conducting hearings on pogos with the ultimate goal of drafting legislation for a total ban. In his third State of the Nation address earlier this year, President Marcos ordered a blanket ban on pogos due to their links to crime, a move expected to displace over 27,000 workers in the industry. The Anti-Organized Crime Commission has earlier estimated that the executive order detailing the pogo ban will be issued in 2 weeks. Around 1.3 million packs of smuggled cigarettes worth about 200 million pesos seized by authorities during operations at warehouses in Quezon City and Caloocan. Initial investigations show the products either lack proper BAR tax stamps or had fake ones. So far, no one has claimed ownership of the warehouses, but authorities have arrested three employees who will now be facing tax evasion charges, possession of excisable goods without payment of excise tax, and violations related to tax stamps.
Ang nag-i-issue ng stamps ay ang BIR. So kinakailangan lahat ng nag-i-import, lahat ng nagma-manufacture ng mga sigarilyo ay dapat mag-apply, mag-rehistro sa BIR ng mga brands at ng mga makina na ginagamit na pang-produce ng mga sigarilyo at dapat bumili ng stamps para ikabit sa mga bawat pakete ng sigarilyo. Isa pang epekto nito ay yung na-perwisyo din yung mga lehitimong mga negosyante na nagbebenta ng sigarilyo na nabayad ang buwis. Siyempre, mas sila nagbabayad ng buwis, mas mataas ang presyo, kaya nagkakaroon ng unfair competition.
E-commerce platform Shopee records a threefold surge in sales during its 9/9 shopping campaign. The online marketplace says 3 million items were sold in the first 2 hours of the September 9 sale, which it attributed to the platform's personalized content and engagement features. Orders in Shopee Video, where sellers upload videos of the exact products they sell, increased 6 times, with total views also up 3 times. Now, Shopee Live, where sellers demonstrate their products real-time, also saw significant growth with a 3.4 times boost in orders. Fashion was a big highlight, with shoppers enjoying as much as 50% sales. Shopee, meanwhile, vows to offer more products and improve its services as the holiday season nears. Airport employees who are affected by the privatization of the Nino Aquino International Airport will be getting incentives. The Manila International Airport Authority has yet to give details, but this is on top of that 25% increase in their basic salary. The MIAA says NAIA personnel whose employment will be transferred to the private concessionaire have already signed their new contracts. The consortium, led by conglomerate San Miguel Corporation, is all set to take over Manila's main gateway tomorrow, September 14th. It has also laid out plans to reassign airport terminals, which is expected to improve the efficiency of runway use. Philippine hotels getting a tech boost with the launch of Dennis Uy's Converge Concierge platform in partnership with Sky Cable. The smart TV solution integrates with existing hotel property management systems, streamlining bookings, guest services, and billing processes. The TV is not just an entertainment hub, it can also be an information platform that shows details about the hotel, as well as news and even flight status updates. Guests can also order food and request other services like massage just by using the platform.
It's all a seamless experience for the customer and also more efficient operations for the hotel. And this is a scalable platform. So this is not only for the big hotels. Huh? This is also for medium-sized, small hotels.
Aside from the hospitality sector, Converge is also eyeing to put up a similar IT solution in other sectors like education. They plan to enter the smart homes business as well, where residents can control their home's lighting and air conditioning with just a few clicks. The Banco Central and the Philippine Statistics Authority, the main implementing agencies of the National ID Project, reiterate they did not violate any rules against subcontracting the project. The Banco Central says it did not subcontract its obligations to AllCard Inc. or ACI, and that the BSP and PSA personnel still managed the operations, while AllCard merely provided equipment, raw materials, and technical support under a lease and supply contract. It adds, the commission and audit team assigned to BSP flagged no issues related to subcontracting in its review of BSP's transactions. The PSA, meanwhile, also standing by the central bank, saying it has fully complied with the agency-to-agency procurement guidelines and its agreement for the printing of national IDs. It notes, as the primary stakeholders in the ongoing implementation of the national ID system, it affirmed its alignment with the BSP's commitment to transparency, accountability, and compliance with the procurement laws. The deal had been recently raised in the Senate. The BSP has since terminated its contract with AllCard, citing ACI's failure to deliver enough raw materials within the specified period, even within the extension granted, and the supplier also failed to maintain the production machinery due to unavailable machine spare parts, causing prolonged machine downtime. Failure to perform other obligations under the contract as well. As of the latest tally, over 55 million cards out of the 90 million registrations have already been issued, leaving a balance of 35 million. Shifting gears, the Philippine Department of Agriculture and the Center for Post-Harvest Development and Mechanization inaugurate a rice processing facility in Quirino Province. The facility was awarded to the Difun Saranay and Development Cooperative, which consists of over 2,300 farmers managing a total of 3,500 hectares of rice fields. The agencies also turned over several machines worth 96 million pesos to help boost the productivity of farmers in the province. Other production machinery such as tractors, harvesters, and threshers were also awarded to 13 farmers cooperatives and associations in Quirino Province. Agriculture Chief Francisco T. Laurel said the initiative is part of the agency's commitment to reduce production losses. While siphoning operations from the sunken MTKR Terra Nova in Bataan finally completed, the Philippine Coast Guard reports 96% of the oil waste has been extracted from the motor tanker, with the remainder solidifying inside the cargo oil tank. The PCG adds the operations could have concluded earlier if not for Tropical Storm Enteng. The motor tanker was carrying over 1.4 million liters of industrial fuel when it sank in rough seas back in July. Good news for motorists, pump prices are going down again next week. The price of gasoline expected to go down by as much as 1 peso 20 centavos per liter, diesel by as much as 160. Officials and industry players cite weak demand for oil from big consumers like China and the U.S. for the price drop. Philippine police bearing more details of the alleged sexual abuse committed by arrested televangelist Apollo Quiboloy on underage members of his religious sect. But his lawyers are dismissing what they say are fabricated testimonies of the alleged victims. Raya Capulong reports.
Horrible. This is how spokesperson Police Colonel Jean Fajardo of the Philippine National Police described the stories shared by the minor victims who were allegedly sexually abused by Kingdom of Jesus Christ Pastor Apollo Quiboloy. According to Fajardo, the victims recounted how they were repeatedly molested by the pastor, who assured them that their virginity remains intact. The victims' testimonies also include Quiboloy's promise that they would go to heaven.
So just can imagine a minor being sexually molested by an individual at sinasabi po nila na as early as 12 or 13 years old, they were allegedly sexually molested by Apollo Quiboloy. Well, ang isang sinasabi is Diyos ang kanilang pinagsisilbihan at kung ano man yung gagawin nila ay yun yung parang kanilang passes to heaven.
Fardo also revealed that the victims and their families would be pursued by the so-called angels of death if they violated the group's code of secrecy. The PNP is trying to identify the supposed angels of death in Quiboloy's group.
Well, hindi natin alam kung ito bang angels of death ay literally mga sinasabing mga goons nila Quiboloy or just a figurative speech na sinasabi para takutin ang mga bata. So kasama po yan sa ginagawa po nating investigasyon.
The PNP also investigate the parents of the victims who are allegedly members of KOJC and aware of the abuse being committed to their children. The PNP is calling on other victims of Kibuloy to come forward and report to the authorities, assuring them of government protection.
Lumalabas na alam di umano ng mga magulang dahil nga parang they are being offered. Asahan niya, sir, na hindi tayo titigil hanggang makuha ng mga batang ito ang hustisyang para sa kanila.
But Kibuloy's camp brushes off the allegations.
Kung may mga bago, I'm sure planted yung lahat yun, kuhan yun, mga manufactured yan. But let them prove their case kasi the accused is presumed innocent. Allegation is not equivalent to guilt.
Meantime, the Bureau of Jail Management and Penology gave its assurance Kibuloy will not receive any special treatment in their facility.
Kung saan po nabigyan ng utos ng korte na dalhin ang isang nakakulong o kahit sino mang tao, wala po kaming magagawa kundi yun na po talaga, ikulong siya doon at kung ano ang meron doon sa seldang yun o kulungang yun. Sa tinitiyak po namin sa part ng BJMP, walang VIP treatment at kahit sino man po yan ay pantay-pantay at initinatrato nating ordinaryong PDL.
Raya Kapulong, ABS-CBN News.